Je pense qu'on a mis en place une bonne méthode technologique. Et j'espère vraiment qu'on arrivera à l'exporter dans un pays capitaliste. Je trouve que la France devrait vite adopter notre système de crédit social pour régler ses mouvements sociaux.
Si vous aviez eu le système de crédit social, il n'y aurait jamais eu les gilets jaunes. On aurait détecté ça avant qu'ils agissent. On aurait pu le prévoir, il n'y aurait pas eu ces événements. C'est l'un des atouts, l'un des grands avantages du crédit social.
Everywhere she goes, Ouyang Haoyu is followed. What she buys, how she behaves, is tracked and scored to show how responsible and trustworthy she is. It's called the social credit system, and in one version now being tested, a person's reputation is scored on a scale of 350 to 950. And Haoyu, with a good score of 752, is okay with it. In fact, most people are.
Is that a mechanism like pushes you to become a better citizen?
It's big data meets big brother, expanding how the government monitors, understands, and ultimately controls its 1.4 billion citizens. Thanks to advances in artificial intelligence and facial recognition, and a web of more than 200 million surveillance cameras.
Are people bothered by privacy concerns?
We think a lot of cameras keep the safety. It's really good. We can accept it.
Companies are experimenting with the algorithms to help the government create the new national social credit system. The government also has pilot projects. In one, citizens are required to do hours of unpaid work to get benefits. And scores are docked for things like littering, a messy yard, gossip, even jaywalking. Video of offenders is shown on the local news. And information collectors like Zhou Aini are paid to report on their neighbors, her quota, 10 entries a month. Like the man who carried a drunk person home. A good deed, she says. Good social credit gets rewarded with perks like cheap loans and travel deals. But a bad score means public shame and worse. Huang Huijun lost a court case and didn't pay. Now he's on a government blacklist. I can't buy airplane or train tickets, he says, and the list goes on. Being discredited makes it hard to get a job or put kids in top schools. The social credit system will go nationwide next year, and few here are willing to criticize it, something that may pose a risk itself for a bad score and the life that comes with it. Janice Mackey Frayer, NBC News, Beijing.
Constantly monitored by facial recognition cameras that are able to instantly put a face to a name. Now the Chinese are also ranked. Teachers at this primary school in China know exactly when someone isn't paying attention. These headbands measure each student's level of concentration. The information is then directly sent to the teacher's computer and to parents. This fifth grader, whom we caught dozing off in class, told us his parents punished him for low attention scores. China has big plans to become a global leader in artificial intelligence. It has enabled a cashless economy where people make purchases with their faces. A giant network of surveillance cameras with facial recognition helps police monitor citizens, students wear uniforms with chips that track their locations. There are even surveillance cameras that monitor how often students check their phones or yawn during classes. Experts and citizens alike are sounding alarms about various aspects of the country's huge push into artificial intelligence. These classrooms are laboratories for future generations.